Yo, what's up, people? Hope you're having a good day or good night, whatever time it is where you are, man. Hope you're having a good one. So, Ghost Rider is here with a cycle. Yo, these are the directions, right? It's going to show you how to pull off the head, put the batteries into the neck, turn that bad boy on. Same thing with the bike. So, when you get yours, you're going to get a big box. You're going to get Ghost Rider by himself like that inside the box. And you're going to get this big foam block. Inside this big foam block is the motorcycle and the flame effects. All right, let's talk about this motorcycle right here. So I have to find a small little screwdriver to get my batteries in. So I've not found that, but it does come with three batteries for the bike and it comes with three batteries for the neck. But I did still want to show you guys the bike though. Look at the detail on look at that tread. He's got some brand new fresh tires from tire discounters. Let's see, anything moving on here? No, we got nothing there, nothing there. Everything seems to be pretty stationary, but the wheels do move, right? And the bike does have sound effects, so that's cool. All right, so you get a little bit of movement right there in the bike. All right, nice brush metal color all over this bad boy. Nothing else is moving on here except for the wheels and a little bit of movement right there. Check out the handlebars. Give a good look like that. Anything going on in the center? Nope, nothing there. All right, let's come across the seat. Look at that little pattern right there. Looks like a nice comfy leather seat for Ghost Rider's butt. Okay, the wheels are a bit stiff. They roll though. You can see it does roll nicely, but you know, it's not an actual toy, so you're not going to get too much out of it, right? But there is some movement there, so that's cool. Okay, and that's pretty much it for the bike. Like I said, I got to find a little screwdriver so I can plug that in, and put those batteries in so we can light that bad boy up. But while we're at it, so it was in just upright like this. That's how it was. Okay, so here's the flame effects that go into the bike. Looks like that. You're going to put that on the back, I believe. Let's see, it's probably going to go, oh wait, I got to check out those directions. So there's a flame effect right there, and a, oh, what is that? A little front like flame effect. While we're at it, here, this is how it goes. I'll show you guys. So the smaller one goes up front and the bigger one goes in the back. Okay, so if you guys want to see that, looks like that. That's how you just connect it. The smaller one just, I mean, the bigger one goes on the back, obviously, minus the extra piece of foam right there. And the other one just goes into the front like this. Okay, let's see here. Snap, come on, get in there. There it is. Okay, so that's how your bike is going to look with its flame effects. Okay, nice translucent oranges and reds and yellows. I like that, man. That's some pretty cool stuff, and I can't wait to find a small screwdriver and put the batteries in. So that's it for the bike, Ghost Rider, Mr. Stiff Man. And I'm saying this because he's very stiff, only because of the leather jacket and the I'm sorry, the pleather jacket and the pleather pants. Head comes off like that, by the way. And you're gonna twist this out. Let's see. We're gonna twist that out. I've already put the batteries in, but you can just hit that little switch to turn it on, and you'll see your light bulb turn on. And we'll get the head, and it looks like that. And if you can see this, it actually flickers a little bit. Let's see. There, see that little flicker? It flickers like a flame. So that's cool. Look at that. All right, that's dope stuff. And then you put the neck back inside the head, give it a couple little twists to lock it back in, and it looks like that. All right, if I could turn the lights off, I would, but there we go. All right, cool. So let's turn that off, that little switch once again. While we're at the head, let's look at the head, right? Look at all that detail in the skull, and the jaw is articulated. Very nice touch, Maz. Very nice touch. I see ya, boy. All right, check that out. Nice grays and black sculpt looks pretty good. Same transparent orange and yellows on Ghost Rider's head. Right? You can actually see, kind of see my hand through, but not really, but it's transparent. But that sculpt on a fire is done very well. I likes that. So let's put that head back on. All right, cool. But because the head is one piece, you have no neck articulation besides looking left and looking right. But you know, with the light effect and the batteries and that whole system there, it's to be expected. Okay, so be careful with this guy. The suit is tight. So as you can see, the arms are only up about this much, right? And we got some pulling right here. Let's use this. We have some pulling right here already, some pulling across the top of the back and here. Right, and the arms are not even up fully, and that's just because the suit is just tight. But what I found out is that if you raise this up, a little bit, you get a little bit more range of motion for those arms. So pull this jacket up over the belt line, and you can get a little more movement here. Okay, there's a little bit of movement there. All right, so just watch out for that. The zipper is functional. All right, and I'm sure if you want to take this off at some point, you could. If you're a customizer, all this stuff comes apart right there. Pull that off. I'm not going to because I like the look, but it is just restricted. So as far as like the joints and everything, even when you turn like that, it stops here because it's pulling right there. And you can see the stretches. All right, so very stiff because of the clothing. So just be aware of that. All right, the bicep cut is at the very, very top, right up inside of there. All right, we are double jointed, but like I said, be careful though. If you bend the arm down, you can get that double jointed. See the stretch right there? You can see it is double jointed, right? So if you bend the arm down, you can get that. Take a look at the gloves and the wrist straps that are going on right here. Look at that, the hand. We have more sets of hands. I'll show you guys that in just a second. All right, same thing on the other side. The back of the jacket looks like that. Got a belt going all the way around the pants. Okay, so the thigh cut is at the very top right here. You can see that going across, right? And once again, tight leather biker outfit. Okay, so you get about right there and you start to feel some resistance from the pants, right? Which means if you keep going, you're gonna split here. That's probably where the most tension is. You're going to split that. So just be careful. But like, I'm starting to feel tension and I can hear the pleather making that crickly, crackly, pleathery sound. So you're limited, but you can try to keep going. But I don't want to stress out the material. I mean, we all know it, without a shadow of a doubt, this material won't hold up. It won't stand the test of time, right? So just be careful as much as you can to make it last, you know, even longer. Tilt and bend looks like that. His waist is very very good. All right, bending forward all the way that much and bending backwards all the way that much. So he's on a really good body. It's just that his clothing is what restricts his articulation. No way around it unless you want to swap him out for something else. Let's check out these biker boots. Sculpted quite nicely. Look at that zipper, look at that buckle. Okay, nice creases in there. Paints look good. A little bit of wear and tear in those boots. All right, going in that much and going out a tiny bit. Going down this much and going up only a tiny bit. But the detail, the sculpt, the color, the paint, it does look good. Now, moving forward, literally moving the leg forward. So you're going to move forward until you feel some stress and some tension, and I feel it about right there, and it starts to pull right here in the butt area, right? You can easily split that seam if you do too much. So as far as getting him seated on the bike, it's going to be a problem. And by it's going to be a problem, he just doesn't have, because of the suit, he just doesn't have the range of motion that, you know, I think, you know, he should. So I've been seeing people, so if you sit him, so as let's just check this out. Let me just be quiet for a second and let's just figure this out. So let's see. Live enough on camera. His butt's in the air still. So if we're gonna lean forward, grab the handlebars like that, we'll simulate grabbing the handlebars with the arm leaning forward. He does bend forward a lot to grab those handlebars, but his butt is not gonna, I don't like his butt just won't, it won't go in the seat because of the way the seat actually is. So it's going to be floating. Let's widen those legs up a bit. So even if like, even not trying to grab the handlebars, he's still going to float a bit because of the design and the curvature of the seat, right? He's still going to float a little bit, but I can press him down a bit, close those legs up, move his foot up here, move the other foot up also on the other side. See that? The feet should be there. Right, you ride a bike, you already know the feet should be there. Right, hands are going to grab the handlebars like that, and his butt is in the air. There's not a way around that. Okay, if you found a way around it, you let me know. But like I said, the suit is what's limiting him from really getting in there, and the shape of the bike is also going to limit his butt from getting like flush with the seat. It's not going to happen. And this is what I meant by pulling the jacket up over the belt. See, the jacket goes up over the belt like that, which allows you to move the arms up more. All right, so that's a little trick for you. That's a little Ghost Rider tips and tricks. Move that belt over, I'm sorry, move the bottom of that jacket over the belt so it's not pulling. Then you can move that arms up even further without much stretching. All right, so there's your Ghost Rider tips and tricks for today. Put that bad boy back. We got the batteries right here. I put two in. We got three for the bike. Here are our Ghost Rider hands. These gloves actually have a lot of detail in them, a lot of sculpt in them, so that's good. Open hands, gripping hands, some open gripping hands, fists are already on them, and some more like open style relaxed hands that look like that. Okay, the next layer, you got some flame effects and our logo stand. Here it is, logo stand for Ghost Rider. Nice flame effects, look at that. Nice flame effects right there. That's gonna plug into his hand. You can see the finger ports right there. That's gonna plug into his hand. Should guess this one. Okay. Very good. Tell you what, boy. No one does flame effects like these guys, bro. They do very well. Alright. And last but not least, the chains. Let's pull this out. Along with the rest of the stand. Here's the chain. All right. You can see a wire going through the chain. You see a little battle damage. The paint looks good on there too. So it's wired. So you're going to be able to bend it and flex it any way you want. Okay. That's the best part about having wired accessories or like a wired cape. Okay. Now we have the chain with the flame embedded in it. Now, of course, you're not going to bend this part because you'll break your flame effect. You're going to leave that part alone. But you are going to bend. Well, can you? Let's see. No, you cannot. This is not wired. So this was meant to be sort of like in this kind of position. Even though it's like flexible plastic, it's not wired. So you're not going to be able to do exactly what you want with it like you will be able to do with that one right there. Okay, there's the rest of the stand. That was like this. That was on top. All right. This was here. All right, then that was on top of that, like that. Just in case you forget how things go, you probably won't because it's easy peasy banana squeezy. I'm just showing you anyway. Looks like my flame effect is in there wrong, but who cares about that. So people, that is it for Ghost Rider. Do me a favor, hit all of those links in the description. All right, Big Bad Toy Store, Instagram, my toy photography. Oh, look at that. This kind of bends down like that. Can we flip this collar up and do anything with it? Let's see. We could just pop it one time for the one time. We could just pop it really. All right. Oh, my head's not in there. It's bobbling. You gotta lock that head in. Like, it's not really meant to do much right there, though. Okay, cool. Here he is, people. Ghost Rider, looking good. He's got his bike. He's got his cycle. That's all I got for you guys. Have a good one. See ya.